It's a little something to start the new year with.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Gary, the person you're with on New Year's Eve is the person you'll be with all year long. Love,
Josie. I agree.
Spoke wisdom. I don't mess with it.
You don't, huh? Well, then you better be sitting right next to me when that clock strikes 12.
You can count on that. Come on, now open your present.
I love the choices you made. The place looks absolutely terrific.
Well, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Hey, I want to thank you for spending this evening with me. You know, that means a lot. You know, I couldn't help but wonder, isn't there somebody else you'd rather spend New Year's Eve with?
We all set, Lou?
Yes, Mr. Harrison.
Excellent. When it's done, I want you gone from Bay City for good.
That's a generous tip.
Think of it as an incentive, Lou.
Hey!
Grandma!
You called and I came.
Come on in.
Okay.
Well, we've been waiting for you.
Well, good. Yeah, I'm here.
Right, Grandpa Carl?
Yes, indeed we have.
Happy New Year, Grandma!
You buy another ticket to Bermuda, junk. Go to hell for all I care. Just get your fiancé out of my face and don't bother coming back.
That's enough! I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying right here.
Well, you know what? If you're staying here, so am I.
Are you ignoring me?
Do you think that I am not capable of throwing you out of here?
Are we forgetting who owns this house?
Oh, thank you for reminding me that I have no rights.
What about my rights? What about Felicia's rights and Greg's rights?
Well, Felicia, what on earth do you think you're going to do? Move in here and live under the same roof with me and John? What?
Such a bad idea.
You can't be serious.
We are written in the stars, Vicky.
Interception!
What are you doing, all right? Man,
come on now. It's your last chance to make it through 96 without making a fool of yourself.
Stop playing games.
Come
on. Oh, look what you did, man. You messed up the box.
Is the rock all right?
The rock is flawless, just like my evening's gonna be here. What are you looking at, Reno?
A desperate man.
Skip this fundraiser and celebrate at home.
No, believe me, I would love nothing better, but I am the public relations director, and I do need to be there. And besides which, my mother was on the committee, so we do need to be there.
A command performance,
mm-hmm.
huh?
Mm-hmm.
Come on. Watts, Sinclair, duty calls.
Yes, sir. We'll see you under the big top.
Okay.
Happy New Year.
Bay City PD, Officer Brian Tibbs. Hold on a second, I'll check. Captain?
Yeah.
Telephone?
Gabe, come on, do you really have to get it?
Is it an emergency?
No.
All right, why don't you handle it? We've got some important business to take care of.
Yes, sir. Cindy, the captain's on his way to Center Street.
So you're trying to keep tabs on me, what?
Oh, open it and find out.
Oh, I'm looking at it. Look, January 1st, breakfast in bed with Jay, dinner with Jay. January 4th, movies with Jay.
Yeah.
Here we go. July 4th, picnic with family and fireworks with Jay.
What kind of fireworks?
Trust me. You'll like
them. I'm sure I will. September 4th, again, read the newspaper with Jay. Now, let me ask you a question. Do they have one of these where we can just fill in our whole life?
We can make one.
We can?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good.
Well, Captain's right. Party's starting. We better get a move
on. We're going. I just wanted to say thank you.
What? Just make sure you're with me when the New Year starts, okay? We'll meet on the steps of the station.
Kidding, you can count on it.
Good. Because I'm very superstitious about this kind of thing.
You are? What do you think? I'm going to stand you up on New Year's Eve?
I don't know.
Never.
Have you lost your mind, John?
Have you?
How would having Felicia move in here help anything?
Yeah.
I know you can help each other too.
Oh, you're just calm down. Listen to what I have to say. What's the matter with you?
I only meant that I wasn't going to leave town.
I know that.
But that's not how it sounded,
John. It sounds ludicrous.
Just hold it. Now, listen. Felicia understands scheduling. She understands about the kind of ups and downs that have been going on around here lately.
John, there have been a few kinks in the works. That's all.
Come on, please. This thing hasn't worked since day one. And Felicia is a born organizer. She's run a restaurant and a bookstore. We need her help.
Where are you going with this, John?
Really, where?
I think that Felicia could be the one person to make this work.
Felicia,
that's
why?
That's right, because we need somebody to run things. Right?
Yeah. Well, all right, I agree with you. We need people. We need someone. Someone to run this thing. Someone. But her.
Me?
Her?
Yes. No one would work as hard or care as much.
Is that, that's because of your great affection
yes,
for
that
me.
Must be it, Charlie. John, you've got to let this go. I cannot stay here.
I want you to stay here. Felicia, sweetie, I need you to stay here. I love you. And I'm certain that once Greg sees you around here helping out, it'll change the way he feels about you.
Well, I would like that.
Yeah. So would I. Yeah, I think that we should look at this as an opportunity rather than an obstacle.
As an opportunity to do what, John? To stomp all over me?
Oh, come on, now, hold it. We wouldn't even be having this discussion if it wasn't for you. You didn't want to go to rehab. You wanted to stay here.
And you resent that.
Just stop being so defensive for 5 minutes and just listen. Now, what do you think?
I guess I could try it. I finished the book on Frankie. I do have the time right now.
Oh, well, that's good, because then I could be your new hobby.
Charlene,
okay, now, come on, let's get to the bottom of this right now. What do you want?
What do I want? In the grand scheme of life,
in
I want
small
to walk
scheme of
again.
Life, any
I
scheme
want
of
to
life.
Just simply.
All right,
walk
well, Felicia
again.
Has just generously offered to help us organize our life.
Am I the only one who sees this? This is wrong. This is not going to work. This
All right,
is too
Charlene.
Close. We
I know
promise.
How difficult this is for you. Believe me, I do. But I think that I could help you if you'd let me.
Good evening, everyone.
Grant, would it be too much to ask for you to knock?
Come knock, Grant. Come.
Well, the door was open, John. I thought perhaps Charlene had left it open for me. You're not ready yet.
No, Grant, I don't feel that I'm really up for a party right now. I'm not a... No.
Oh, come on. Let me talk you into it.
No, it would take me a very long time to get myself pulled together.
Charlene, I could help you.
What?
I could help you get ready if you want me to.
I thought you were supposed to be watching Vicky's kids.
Change of plans. Carl's watching the kids.
And you just got yourself a little hand-me-down tuxer, huh?
Give it a rest, Jake.
Ooh. Ooh. Those cowboy boots, they're smoking. Those are going to go great when you get the old hop on your horse and ride out of town when you see what goes down here tonight.
Stop it, all right? Just leave it alone. Come on, let's get out of here. Vicky's inside.
What am I doing wasting my time out here? I mean, I do, after all, have the first dance. Be cool.
I'm doing well, thank you.
Are you looking for someone?
Yes, I am. And there he is.
Hey. Happy New Year, Sandy.
Hi, thank you.
Tomas.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. This is quite a spread. The stuffed mushrooms are to die for.
Well, Pauline is in charge of the catering. I'll tell her they're a hit.
Mm. You guys haven't seen Grant, have you?
No, not yet.
Excuse me.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi. Yeah, yeah.
I have the first dance, please.
Excuse me, this
thank
is...
Thank you
okay,
so
don't
much.
Forget who my date is, buddy.
I'm not going out with you.
You are absolutely beautiful.
Happy 97.
Well, thank you very much, and happy new year to you, and, you know, may the new year bring, I don't know, finishing with Vicky.
Excuse me?
Well, our house. I get the feeling sometimes you are going to be building there forever. How long are you going to keep working on that place?
As long as it takes. Excuse me.
Listen, I need to speak to you later. It's a muy importante day.
May I have this dance?
I'll catch up with you later.
Sure.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Bud,
I'm really sorry.
Okay, go easy. I don't want anybody seeing me doing this. So you don't be a little bit more careful here? You're not going to make it through the night.
I know exactly what I'm doing.
You look pretty, Grandma.
Yes.
You're a vision.
A vision? Well, I wondered why you had called me. I didn't really think you were all that interested in my outfits.
It was Grandpa Carl's idea.
Yes, that makes a lot more sense.
Come on! Can we show you some more Christmas presents we got?
Let's yes, build I'd a love castle. To see
okay, I'll be yeah. right up, okay? In just a minute.
Okay, come on.
You used the children to get me over here.
Yes, I did. And they were thrilled to see you. As am I. Oh, come on, come. Don't be angry. You look lovely. Can I take your coat?
You're not going to the fundraiser?
Now I thought it'd be more comfortable for you if I'd stayed clear of the guys on down in Center Street. But when I raise my glass at midnight, my wish will be for you, for us to be together, and for us to be as happy as we were in New York. When we shared our first kiss. Do you remember? New Year's Eve.
Hello! Happy New Year!
Hey. Amanda! Amanda, what are you... Well, welcome home.
She was welcome. My Christmas present. She and Ali arrived under my Christmas tree.
I truly believe, Amanda, that you're the finest gift that your mother could possibly have received.
Are you coming?
Yes, right away. Excuse me.
Oh, what brings you back to Bay City, Amanda?
You? Or to be more precise, helping my mother get over you.
You'll have quite a job. Yes. Well, is this just a visit, or may I look forward to working with you down at Corey?
Expect to look forward to working with me exclusively while I'm here, as long as I'm here.
Hey, you guys are gonna need new shelves for all that loot.
Ha ha, you guys, look, terrific.
Amanda!
Oh my God. Hey, you guys, these are from Allie.
Oh, thanks.
So have a go. Wow. And we'll have to get you guys together soon for a visit, yeah?
Yeah.
Mom, let's go. We're late as it is. Goodbye.
Oh, wow.
What, no? No New Year's wish.
You know what I wish.
You think tricking my mother into this visit is going to help build her trust back? She leaves more of you behind every day.
So listen, if we get separated later, there's something I want to say to you.
What?
I want to thank you for being in my life this year.
Bobby.
And there's some stuff I wanted to say on our first date, but Jake's accident kind of cut that short.
Hey, guys. Vic, you're an absolute genius. You know, Charlie loved that hockey stick.
Oh, good.
How was your Christmas, okay? Sorry.
That's okay. The boys, they had a great time.
Okay.
How you doing?
Hi.
How you doing, beautiful?
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Listen, I have an update for you. I spoke to personnel, and they're going to rotate some part-time people. So you're stuck with me a couple times a week.
Whoa, I don't know if I can accept that, you know? You should be studying.
Well, listen, no, it's all worked out. It's all good.
One day at a time, all right? Tomas, did you get my message?
Yes, I did. What's up?
About the foundation? Would you excuse us for a minute, Sharon?
Of course I
thanks.
Mother?
Hey,
I'm so sorry to interrupt, John.
I'm sorry. Excuse me.
You want me on the board? But Grant, I'm not qualified. I mean, I'm just a student.
Tomas, people like you know what it's like to get through med school. I need your input. And Cindy Brooke is already providing me with a wealth of information.
I mean, if you're sure, I would be more than honored to.
I'm positive. People like you will make my foundation a success.
Thank you.
Champagne, sir?
Sure. Good to help.
Thank you.
Okay. Poncherino is gone, so I think it's time. What do you think?
No.
I'm kidding. Go for it. Let's go.
Get under the ring.
You mean?
The ring.
It's
gone.
All right. Look around. Maybe.
No, it didn't go anywhere. I don't have any holes in my pocket. Somebody stole it.
Nobody stole it. Nobody even knew you had it except for me and you. Bobby Reno.
Must be a real switch from the way you usually spend New Year's.
Oh, yeah? How's that?
I don't know. I could imagine you at a classy country club party where there's an orchestra playing and you're surrounded by debutantes all over the place.
You're not even close.
I'm not? Oh. Maybe I need to get to know you better. You know what?
We have a toxic waste situation that needs immediate attention.
Oh, no.
Okay, we gotta go, huh? We gotta go.
There you are. I've been looking all over for you.
Really? Well, I gotta work on my speech.
I'm waiting for our dance.
Our dance. Tell you what, Donna, I'll dance with you later, I promise. But for right now, I gotta work on my speech.
The soul of romance. Hi. What's so fascinating in there?
Beats me. How you doing, Donna?
Oh, Matthew Corey changing diapers. Poor boy.
Me or him?
Matthew is not a boy, that's for sure. No, you're the lovesick puppy. I know it's hard when you see two people who aren't right for each other. And Sophia's out of her league, and Matthew should really be with a more mature woman who's already had a family and done that, who just wants to enjoy being with a man.
Someone like you?
No, not someone like me. I've already done that. I'm planning to spend the evening with your father, and you're going to help me. Go, have a good time. Consider yourself officially off duty.
Are you sure? You don't want me to stick around or
please,
anything?
Please, Dante is asleep. You were there for the crunch. Cut loose. In fact, please, dance one for me.
All right.
So, you want to dance?
I would, but these shoes, they're pinching my toes.
Ah, the shoes.
And Matt, the idea of people watching us, I don't know, I'd be tripping all over you. It's going to make me self-conscious. No, I mean, I'm not used to this.
What are you used to?
Guess. Okay. I want to know how you see me New Year's Eve 2 years ago.
You were with a bunch of friends in Times Square watching the ball drop.
Are you kidding? With all those cops in my family? No, no. I had to watch it on the tube, surrounded by my aunts and uncles and too much food.
Well, you know, I've really got my work cut out for me if I'm going to get to know you a little better.
Well, not that hard to figure out.
Oh, yeah, I bet you have some deep, dark secret you're keeping from me.
Charlene? I followed you here. It just took me a little longer than I expected.
What exactly do you want?
Well,
I think we left a few things hanging out at the farm. I'm sorry.
What? I mean, you seem pretty clear about how you felt, and if I were you, I would probably feel exactly the same way. What is it?
You expecting John?
Yes, I am. But he doesn't know about this, so...
Mm. I need a minute of your time. What exactly were you thinking you would do out at the farm?
Well, I don't know. I hadn't thought it through. You want to know, don't you? Okay. Mm-hmm. I could shop. I could run errands. I could keep all of your appointments for you with the therapist. I could drive Gregory to school if that was necessary.
And this really would not bother you?
No, it wouldn't bother me. Charlene, between you and me, I think if I did come out to help you, maybe I could get rid of some of the guilt that I have about you. And God knows I miss John. I would do almost anything to be with him more.
Apparently you would.
Yes, and I do remember a time when we were actually friends.
We'll never be friends again. But I may have been too quick to dismiss your offer. You might just be terrific motivation.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. To be blunt, seeing you every day might just be the motivation I need to get myself out of this chair.
So what you're saying is that you want me to come and live with you at the farm?
Where would you be sleeping?
Well, that's about it for the night.
Oh, come on, can we stay
way past your bedtime. No, your mother will... No, the deal was one chapter.
It's so unfair.
Here's a poem I've been reading thus, Stephen. By fairies' hands, their knell is rung. By forms unseen, their dirge is sung.
What's a knell?
A knell is a funeral bell, an ominous sound usually associated with death, funerals.
And a dirge?
A dirge. What's it sound like? It's a song of grief.
Spooky.
Well, not really. It's perfectly natural. Come on, let's get this little one upstairs. Look at him. He's already off in the land of Nod. Let's get him up the apples and pears.
What's apples and pears?
Apples and pears. That's rhyming slang for stairs.
I remember this book. It's Carl's favorite. It had one of his favorite poems by Thomas Gray. Wait.
PJs, and I'll come up and read you the rest of that poem. Alas, regardless of their doom, the little victims play. No sense of their ills to come. No care beyond today.
What do you think, Carl? Think. People are in danger. Vicky is in danger. Grant's making his move.
No sense have they of things to come, of ills to come. What? What ills to come?
Bob?
Hmm.
Hi. I was afraid you'd left.
No. I still have something to talk to you about.
You did it, didn't you, Reno? You couldn't stand to lose, so you had to pull it fast, like, didn't you, my friend? You saw the ring, Bobby. You didn't want me to show it to Vicky, so you took it. When did you do that, my friend? Let me go!
When
did you do that, Bobby? When you cut in on the dance? You're nothing but a two-bit loser. You're gonna go to jail for this, you know that? You are gonna go to jail.
I knew Jake's Christmas dream is a fluke. I've only been back a couple days, and he's already in the middle of a mess.
Valuable for me. You stole the ring, didn't you, Mr. Reno?
I didn't steal anything, and you're drunk.
Shut up, man!
Wait, listen, Jake, I'm sure there's just a misunderstanding here.
Punk, that's a misunderstanding. The misunderstanding is he thought he was going to get away with it, didn't you?
All right. Okay. All right, enough now. Listen, Bob, would you mind emptying your pockets so that everybody can just get back to partying, please?
Sure. It's a waste of time, but I'll indulge you. Vicky, I have no idea how this got in my pocket.
You're so stupid you kept the evidence.
All right, gentlemen, that's enough. I'll handle this from here on.
Good, arrest him.
Wait, Jake, just a minute. Now, you've got the ring back. It doesn't really matter how Bobby ended up with it.
He didn't end up with it. He stole it. That's how he ended up with it.
Jake, you probably put it in my pocket. You would love it if I looked like a criminal in front of these
people. I'm going to make you look a hell of a
criminal. No, stop, get off me, Jake!
Knock it off! Do you want to end up spending the rest of the night ringing in the new year behind bars? Do you? Now, you got a choice. You want to press charges against him? What's it going to be? Do this, do you?
Vicky, I did not steal that ring.
Look, I gotta get out of here.
Vicky. I'm sorry. That's it, Reno. You stay away from me, right, and you right, stay right. away from Vicky, or you'll never live to see 97. All right? Get off me!
I got him!
Get off me!
Come on, I got him.
Goodness, did you hear that?
All right, everybody.
Was that as ugly as it sounded?
Hey, where are you going?
Dad, I'm sorry. I have to leave early.
Well, can I give you a ride?
No. Sorry. I'd like to be alone.
Okay.
Hey, hey, Michael. Everyone's looking all over for you. There's a crisis at the hospital. Some VIP's been admitted, throwing a fit, threatening to sue the board.
No, what?
Yeah, he's looking for some high mucky mucky. You better go talk to him. He's in 412.
412. Oh, fine.
Go on. Tibbs, get a trace on this call. It's a lonely woman threatening to jump from a terrace. Hi. Can you tell me where you are? No, I don't need to know that, but I'd like to talk to you. I'd like to... You know, get to know a little bit about you. Why don't we start out with names? My name is Josie. Hi, Dorothy. No, it's okay. Listen, this is what I'm here for. Don't worry, I have all the time in the world. In fact, if you want to talk all night, I'll be here.
So Felicia is planning on moving into the farm
Well, we've agreed that we would give it a try.
And you two have worked this out.
We're just right in the middle of working out.
We've decided that I really should stay in the guest room. That's because it would be more appropriate for Gregory, you know, his age.
Yeah, and I certainly appreciate that.
Yes, and I think you should hide the butcher knives, you know, just in case.
I have no intention of hiding anything. So I am truly moved at how selfless both of
you
are.
John, is that what you think this is? No, this is not. No. I have a goal here, and Felicia happens to share that goal. This is about results. This is not about motives.
We both want Charlene to walk as soon as possible.
I think this can work. So, excuse me.
Sure.
Thank you.
Charlene?
Yeah?
I hope this is a real good year for you.
Thank you.
Well, that was warm.
You're incredible. What do you tame lions to?
Believe me, I'll let you know when this starts to get a little too much. But right now, I am so thrilled because I'm going to see you every single day.
You really think we can do this?
I don't know. We'll probably kill ourselves in the process.
Alas, regardless of their doom, the little victims play.
That's it, Dad. Think. Who are the victims? Vicky, Bobby, Jake. They're at the party. They're playing. They're in danger.
Victor. You're much earlier than I thought. What, don't you trust me?
To tell you the truth, I think you are the only person I do trust. You know, actually, I am so mad I just spit.
Uh-oh. What's happened?
I don't know anyone, actually, as well as I thought I did. Thank you for taking care of the boys tonight.
Oh, not at all. It's always my delight. They ate popcorn, and I read Treasure Island.
I wish I would have stayed home.
You didn't have a good time?
It was okay. Happy New Year.
Yes. Yeah, the same to you. With all my blessings.
I knew every single word that came out of your mouth was going to be the absolute truth. You were the kindest, most honest, most loving man I have ever known, and there will never be anyone like you. Oh, God. I wish you would hold me again.
There's a lot you don't know about me, Victoria. You don't know me well enough to trust my word. Or to think that tonight was anything more than what it was.
Bobby, are you trying to tell me that you didn't have anything to do?
I already said that. I'm not asking you to trust me. I'm asking you to listen to your heart. That will tell you the truth.
I want to believe what you said, but...
You do believe me, don't you?
I like them together.
Who? Matthew.
Yeah, it's nice to see him with someone born in this century.
Oh, Amanda. Matthew and Donna split up, and they took it very well. We don't need to score points on that. Would you like one?
Oh, thank you. But you like Sophia?
Yes, I do. I don't know her very well, but I like the way Matthew is with her. He seems happy. Well, that makes me happy. Which leads me to my next question. Are you happy? Is anyone happy?
That's relative.
Yeah, that's the trouble.
Hi, look.
Hi, Dick.
Michael wanted you to know that he was called away suddenly.
What's that?
Well, it's almost midnight and he needs to make the toast.
Oh, no, Nick, not me, not me. Come on,
Mom. Mom, no. You'll think of something. Come on.
Think of something.
She's got to.
Not always.
You always, yes,
okay,
always
right,
you.
Have fun.
Buddy.
How you doing?
I know that 96 wasn't a good year for you, and I just hope that 97 will be better.
Well, thanks, but actually, I'm ending 96 in a good way.
Well, glad to hear that. All right, gotta go.
Yes. Good for me.
Hello, darling.
I'm not dancing with you.
Pull in your claws, Cindy. I'm about to make good on my part of our arrangement. Play along now. Excuse me, Gabe. Morning, may I have the pleasure?
I don't know.
Gabe won't mind, will you, Gabe?
Sure.
You know, it's fine. Yeah, it's
okay, thanks.
Can I have this dance, Captain?
Certainly, Miss Brooke.
What is it?
I think I'd prefer to sit this one out.
If you prefer.
Hello, Lorna.
Amanda.
Amanda, aren't you going to say hi? It's nice to see you again.
I was just remembering being married to you while you carried on behind my back with Lorna.
That's over, Amanda. In fact, I'm now engaged.
Yeah, she is. As a matter of fact, to an old friend of mine, Gabe McNamara.
Yes, that's right. I think I'm going to go join him. Excuse me.
So how have you been keeping busy, Grant? Trying to kill any ex-wives lately?
Mind if I cut in? Help yourself.
Thanks.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to start with asking you to join me in thanking all of our wonderful corps of volunteers for making this such a spectacular evening. They did a great job.
Thank you for coming. And most of all, thank you for your generosity to our hospital. The good news is we're on our way to meeting our goal.
Sophia, could you watch Dante for a minute? He's wide awake, and I want to just spend a minute with Joe when midnight comes. He's always holding on. Here we go. He's a little fussy, okay? Okay. Oh, you know what? We're at a party? Oh, I've got an idea.
Short, because the year is almost over. Now, you're all here to have a good time, and I understand that, but we're also here for a very important cause, to show our support and commitment to this hospital and to our community.
Hello, what did... Hello?
Michael. Welcome to the SS Love. The cruise to nowhere starts behind this curtain. You are too much. Come here. May I have this dance?
Minutes left of 1996. My wishes for the new year are very basic. Good health. Dreams fulfilled. Goals reached. And most important of all, love realized. Let's welcome 1997 with peace in our hearts.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to start the countdown. Are you ready?
Yes! Oh! Can you do me a favor? Do you think you can walk over to the door and let the people who are waiting for you in? They just want to help you. That's all they want to do. Okay, good. It's gonna be okay. Just unlock the door, Dorothy. Yeah. Okay, you won't have to be alone anymore. Good. Thank you. Listen, be gentle with her, okay? Great season. I'm gonna miss Gary.
No, you're not. Not if you hurry. We got some seconds left on the clock.
Oh, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year.
I shouldn't have come.
You're not coming over until we've had this out. You wrecked the most important evening of my life, and then you play dumb? She may buy your stories, Mr. Reno, but I don't.
Jake, let it go.
You need to make a decision, Vicky. You need to figure out if you're going to believe somebody who's been a friend of yours for your entire life or some drifter who builds tree houses.
You're telling me I need to choose?
What?
I choose no one. I want you both to leave.
Vicky,
I mean it, leave. Please,
you
Jake.
You cannot do this to me.
So begins another year without you, Ryan.